collection of books as of October 2017. This collection of books has been fully transcribed into 600 different languages. 600 different languages. When these translations came about, we like to call them translations, but there are many versions of the Bible. Many versions of the Bible. And some, I told you on the last time we were together, some are not necessarily translations, they are mere interpretations. Amen. And we said that we have to be careful that we are not governing, per se, our lives by the interpretations, but the true translations. I shared with you that Dr. Peter Gomes, who was a professor of divinity at Harvard Medical School, he produced a Bible that took every reference to women out of it. Every reference to women out of it. He was a known and prolific homosexual. So everything that said that a man should be with a woman, he included that a man should be with a man. That is not a biblical translation.
Amen.
That is rather his personal interpretation. Eugene Peterson produced what's known and what's very, very famous as the Message Bible. And there are certain areas in that particular Bible, although many times I like to read it, where he gives his own interpretation of how he felt when he was writing it, and not God's actual translation. Some of the most correct or accurate versions of the Bible include the King James Version, the New International Version, and one of the most accurate ones as of last year, which is known as the New King James Version of the Bible. When we are looking at the Bible, dear hearts, we understand that it is in two different testaments, two different agreements, two different covenants. The first covenant is called the Old Testament. The second is called the New Testament. In the Old Testament, it is an account of the children of Israel. And oftentimes, dear heart, even in the dream that I had last night, oftentimes what we see in the children of Israel back in the Bible day is actually what we see in our own personal lives. Oftentimes you will see that God blessed the children of Israel, yet they went back to the badness of their ways. And you will see constantly over and over and over again that God will place them into bondage. They will say, Lord, if you get me out of this, I'll never do it again. Yet when he gets them out, they find themselves back and even in deeper of a rut than they were the first time.
Amen.
To the point that God himself had to say, hey, won't you return to me? Uh-huh. And those foolish people said, Lord, wherein shall we return? In other words, we didn't know we had even messed up.
Uh-huh.
And God said, I will lovingly draw you to myself. Because the bullocks, the lamb, the doves, all of those sacrifices were imperfect before God's eyes. So he had to come to what we call the New Testament,
mm-hmm.
which is an account of the life and ministry of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
He became the perfect and the last sacrifice. Mm-hmm. So when Paul wrote the epistle saying, when the blood of bullocks and doves could not do, God sent his son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh, because he became our ultimate sacrifice.
Uh-huh.
One